Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. We have a visitor today. But so first wanted to kind of talk to you guys about my little update and what, you know, you guys are going to be doing if you guys are following me on this little bodybuilder style diet. So basically this week we're going to have one cheat meal, and I just, you know, if you know you can get back straight on the plan right after, then just go ahead and go as crazy as you want to be with it. Ideally, for, you know, not to like go too crazy, most people try to stick it into just one meal of the day. But of course it's up to you. However, if you are one of those type of people that kind of like regrets things after you do something like that, then I would just recommend just sticking it to one meal, or try not to go too crazy in general. Just relax, just kind of have it a day's relax and just have fun. Don't intentionally go overboard. You're going to make yourself feel sick. And if you do start feeling sick, it is going to be for maybe the next 2 or 3 days. So I would just recommend not going like that way. And then for the rest of the week, or whenever your week actually starts for your new week, just go ahead and go back to the plan. But we are going to be going into a calorie deficit of 100. So I was at 1700 to 1750, and I'm going down to 1600 to 1650 calories. So we're just going to be reducing that whenever your week starts, and then whenever you're ready, you can have that cheat day. Usually it's kind of planned for the most part. If you're on keto and you kind of want a little bit of carbs, you can always do that too. But I do recommend sticking to keto desserts, if anything. And then for, you know, obviously the carbers, or the, the ones like changing into keto, it's just up to you what you want to do with that. But you can, you know, you can also do low carb desserts too. But I mean, you can also just do whatever you like. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So I will get started on telling you guys how to do my little acai smoothie. So for this recipe, all you really need is 3 things and also some ice on the side. But yeah, so I got these acai packs that are unsweet and great for these like low carb things, especially if you want that flavor. And you're just going to be adding 2/3 cup of the organic coconut milk, unsweetened. And it's just going to be the whole. So you want to stick it in the fridge overnight so it can get nice and thick. And then you can just scoop it out how much you need. And then you're going to be taking a semi-frozen, not too frozen, because then you're going to really struggle like I did to take it out. But just put a whole pack of the acai, single pack of the sambazon, and just make sure it is unsweetened. And then all you're gonna need to do is add a cup of unsweetened coconut milk. Whenever you're done with it, just make sure to add a cup of ice. If you want it thicker, you can always add more than that, but just about a cup is fine. If you have too much liquid, like it's just too full, go ahead and just kind of split it in half and go add like half an ice or something like that, and it'll give you that nice smoothie texture. And then you're just going to go ahead and blend it. You can do it before or after. Just add about 2 tablespoons of sweetener of choice. I always use a monk fruit, but that's optional, of course. However, if you like it sweeter, I do recommend maybe 3 to 4 tablespoons. If you're not really a big sweet fan, just stick to the 1 to 2 tablespoons. And that is all. So I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.